Hello everyone, welcome back to this new video, where I am going to show you how to embed the Report Server Designer in an application using JavaScript. Report Server is a powerful application that allows you to store, manage, and deliver reports for your users. Embedding Report Server in your application provides seamless access to your reports, without switching between different applications. Before embedding the designer to your application, you should be aware of two items needed to embed, as it is not possible to integrate the designer simply with the frame. Report Server's Reporting Service. This service is used to interact from your application. Bold Reports Reporting Tools. Use JavaScript Report Designer from the Bold Reporting Tools along with Report Server's Reporting Service for embedding. The Report Server Designer also builds using the same service. For this demo, I am going to use an HTML application. I already have the basic HTML application named embeddeddesigner.html file. Now, I copy the necessary scripts to load the Report Designer control from the Report Server from the documentation and add it inside the head tag. Now I am going to initialize the Report Designer control in the HTML application. I add the div tag inside the body tag, which acts as a container for Bold Report Designer. Inside the div tag, I add the ID attribute value as designer. The HTML element can be specified using the ID attribute. Next, I add the inline style attribute, which specifies the width and height of the div element. Next, I add the script tag inside the body tag and initialize the Report Designer control inside the script tag. Now, configure the Report Server in the HTML application to render the Report Designer control. For that, service URL, Report Server URL, and service authorization token are required to perform API actions with Report Server. Okay, let me add them one by one. First, I add the service URL. This URL specifies the web API service URL. It contains the server name, service name, and REST API name, and the format is http://reportserver-name/reporting/report-service/api/designer. In this demo, since I have hosted the Report Server on my local machine, I have specified the Report Server name as localhost along with the port number in which I am hosting it. You can use your own report server name. Next, reporting/report-service represents the service name of the report server. And API/designer represents the web API name of the report server. Next, I add the report server URL. Here it specifies the server name and site information, and the format is http://report-server-name/reporting/api/site/site name. As before, I set the report server name as localhost along with the port number. Site/site1 represents the site from which I am going to load the report in the Report Designer control. Since I load the designer control from site1, I specify site/site1. You can specify your own. Finally, add the service authorization token from the report server. For that, I log into my report server. Next, I open the user profile page. Here, I click the personal access token from the top panel. You can change the token expiration period here. To generate a token, I click the Generate Token button and confirm it. Once the token is generated, to copy that I click to copy. Then, I add the service authorization token, which is copied from the report server, to the HTML application. Save the file. Now everything is ready to load the report designer. I run the application. You will see the report designer control is loaded in the browser. Here you can add some report items. And you can save the report in the report server. Here I showed you how to embed the Report Designer from Enterprise Report Server. You can also embed the report designer from Cloud Report Server. I have provided the documentation link in the video reference. Let me summarize. I have shown you how to create an HTML application and the scripts that are referenced to render the report designer control and how to initialize the report designer control. I have also provided the documentation link in the description below for the steps that are followed in this video. If you found this video useful, don't forget to click the like button and subscribe to our channel to watch more videos like this. Thanks for watching.